According to the American College of Sports Medicine, approximately 35% of elite athletes suffered from disordered eating, burnout, depression, and/or anxiety. In the public eye, athletes are seen as the epitome for success, whether that is their physical build, lifestyle, income, opportunities, and more. However, many people do not realize the intense factors that come into play with being an elite athlete, whether that is collegially or professionally. While it is the dream for most to become a collegiate or professional athlete and achieve the success and fame that follows, the pressure to perform at the highest level, the constant talk and judgment from the fans and media, and the countless hours dedicated to the sport can lead to declining mental health, which calls for better support for these hardworking athletes in the sports world. Collegiate and professional athletes must maintain peak physical performance and meet high expectations from coaches, fans, and more. This can lead to a very stressful environment for athletes, as they must balance all these factors. Athletes are expected to always perform at the highest level, and this can cause a mental toll on some of the best athletes in the world. This was seen with Simone Biles. From a CNN report by Savannah Stewart, she shares how Simone had to step away from gymnastics and opted out of the Tokyo Olympics as she was suffering from a mental block called the twisties, which causes gymnasts to lose track of their position midair. Simone is just one example of the impact that pressure can have on the top athletes. Constant talk and judgment from the fans and media can also have a toll on athletes' mental health and personal life. This can cause stress, anxiety, and sometimes depression. An example of this is Russell Westbrook, an NBA player on the LA Clippers, who spoke out about the constant online hate him and his family receive. He shared with the press that this is just a game. It is not the end all be all, but the moment becomes where my name is being shamed, it becomes an issue. He goes on to share how the constant scrutiny and hate from people on social media has weighed on him and his family. This can lead to lower performance and again impact his mental health and well-being, not just as a player, but as a human being. The demands of maintaining peak athleticism can take a toll on many athletes. The NCSA shares how Division I athletes commit 60 hours to school and sport per week. The Bureau of Labor Statistics shares how professional athletes work more than 40 hours per week over many months, including training, traveling, and competing. The demands of training and competing can cause an athlete to sacrifice personal relationships, leisure time, and partaking in social activities. This sacrifice can cause the feeling of isolation and loneliness in athletes and can also lead to physical strain. With the countless hours that athletes put in, they can lead to mental fatigue and burnout and exhaustion. The indicated components create much worry about athlete mental health and the push for more support and resource for these athletes. It is important that as a community, people take action to promote better and more efficient mental health services for athletes, whether that is having licensed officials on staff or primary care physician that can diagnose and help set up a mental health specialist with athletes. It just takes one step forward to change the course of athlete mental health. Are there any questions?
I had one question, and I was wondering what are some specific changes that you think sports organizations should do to prioritize better supporting the mental health of athletes?
Personally, I think that there should be increased access to mental health professionals. There can be education and awareness programs regarding mental health and sports facilities, teams, and programs, and also creating personalized mental health plans for all athletes. And if possible, creating more flexible training schedules for athletes so they're not currently under continuing stressful time frames of training. Does anyone else have any more questions? All right. Thank you for listening to my speech.